Well, the Navy is blaming this on sequestration, saying that defense spending cuts won't allow for the money needed to fix the sub. This afternoon, the shipyard commander and union heads met with yard workers right in the middle in the mall in the yard to talk about the impact of scrapping the Miami and the Navy's decision and the continued ramifications of sequestration. The same highly trained men and women proud to get the nuclear sub, the USS Miami, back into the fleet after last year's destructive fire will now start the complicated process of rendering it inactive and safe for recycling.
Nuclear submarines, they're our nation's number one platform for arsenal and for defining and defending our national security. We don't have money to fix one of our nuclear submarines because of sequestration. That's a problem.
Are you finding yourself having to console people today?
We've been doing that right along because, you know, we've had, you know, the pay freeze, the hiring freeze.
The sub deactivation is adding to the unease already brought by furloughs for 1,000 workers. The rest were exempt when the Navy deemed their work critical, but that may not be the case for long.
But come October 1st, the new fiscal year, you know, all of our heads are back on that chopping block. And Secretary Hagel made it very clear that furloughs will not be sufficient to meet the budget constraints of sequestration. There will be layoffs.
The unknown is what's bothering most people right now.
So you have the stress of furloughs, you have the stress of impending layoffs, and with the Miami, it's one more thing people are thinking about.
Frustration is aimed at Congress and the inability to find a budget solution.
Our Maine and New Hampshire delegates are really 100% back of us, and we just got to convince the other 80%.
We've had people furloughed, we've lost schedules, and now we've lost a nuclear submarine.
The process of removing the reactor and stripping the sub down is long and complicated and requires all the same expertise that it takes to actually put it together. According to the Navy, once that done, it will be shipped to Washington State and cut up into scrap. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.